Hi everyone, today I want to do this tutorial. Hopefully you guys like it. It's a very pretty purple look and it's requested by my friend Kenia, whom I really really love. I've been knowing her since 8th grade, so she's my old viejita friend. She's old. I know, she's not old. She's my age. But her sister's getting married and she's going to she's going to wear a purple dress, which I normally don't do. I don't do looks like the same color of the dresses, but in this case I really think she's gonna really really look really pretty with this look, so I did this especially for her. I'm gonna get close my eyes. I totally you want to add fake lashes to this look. It really 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 makes a difference. So hopefully you like it. The products that I used is Bevo foundation without SPF. You want to make sure that you wear something that does not have SPF for the pictures, especially for the pictures, because you don't want it to look like you have like a white mask on your face or like a halo type of thing. So this is really good. It's called Bevo in the color sand. This is the only one that I have without SPF, so that's why I'm using it. 4444 I'm using the Coastal Scents palette, the matte and a little bit of the shimmery, not a lot but just a little bit. I'm using the 10 blush palette as well, and the color that I'm using for my cheeks is this beautiful coral color right here. This is what it looks like. And 4444 concealing my face, I'm using the, where is it? I'm using my camouflage palette. And once again, I mix those two colors. For my lips, I was using this pink, I forget the name. Yves Saint Laurent. I don't want to mess it up or butcher it, but I think that's what it's called. And this is the pink color I was using. I'm going to show you the name of it because it doesn't really have a name, or I just can't see it. I'm kind of blind. So this is how that looks. And this is the color. And for lip gloss, I'm using the Liquid Lip Shine from NYC. It's 555. Yeah, but I took off the lipstick and I'm only wearing this color right here. So, what else? Oh, 444444. Contouring, I'm wearing Milani because I like contouring with bronzers. So, this is the name of it. And my mom came up, she just came right now, and she showed me this 24/7 mineral immediate results. I don't know for what. It's for mineral highlighting palette, anti-aging or something. I totally love it. This is the colors that it has, and I just literally went like this. And I went so that's why I have that little shine right there, because this makes it. I don't know where you purchase it, but if you can find it, buy this. So that's basically it. I really love it. Hopefully she likes it. I really really love it. I'm gonna get close, see if you can see it. Alright, well, if you want to know how I did this look, please keep watching. Please rate, comment, and subscribe. Bye, Kenya. I forgot to mention that it'll be a good idea if you wear a translucent powder at the end of your makeup just to set it. And it really, really makes a difference. My face right now, it looks very set. Probably not in the camera, but it does really look set and shiny, and it's just ready to go. So that's what you want, you know? A very finished look. So hope you like it. Bye. Okay, to start this look, I'm going to start with the eyeshadow primer potion in Eden. Looks like that. This is gonna make, I really recommend you using a primer for your eyes, because it's gonna make the makeup stay. Stick like glue. So I'm going to take it all the way to my eyebrow because I am going to fill it in. So,
for listening to Work to Magic Night 2.5.
Okay. After that, I'm going to be using my Coastal Scents palette in matte. And the color that I will be applying, it's going to be this color right here. It's like a very bright pink, purple, but I'm going to mix it a little bit with that purple right there. Okay. But I'm going to add more of this color than this. Okay. And I'm just going to take it to my lid. Just like that. And if you see, I'm just patting it. I'm not smudging it or anything like that. I'm just patting it. Okay, and I'm going to use a blending brush that looks like this. This is a 224. It's my favorite, actually, my favorite blending brush. I'm just going to lightly brush that. Just like that. Okay. The next color that I'll be using is going to be this purple right here. And this. I'm actually going to mix this that looks like a blue-purple color. I don't know, but I'm going to mix those two. With my blending brush. And I'm going to take it to the crease. Now I'm going to clean my brush a little bit. You can use a wipey, you can use anything, but I don't want it to be wet, so I'm just going to, just doing this. Okay, so I'm going to add a little bit more purple to my my lid. And this time I am going to take the second purple instead of the bright. I'm going to take this one. Okay, hopefully you can see it there. And for highlight, I'm going to use, where is that little, and bring it out. Oh, okay, I'm going to use this one. I'm going to use this Avon Oval Options eye pencil. Looks like this. It's like in the pearly color. So I really like this one. I'm going to use it as a highlight. And I'm going to use it right in this part of my eye. Like always. This is what's going to make your eye look brighter and bigger. Or awake. And I'm going to add a little bit in that highlight. The highest point on my eyebrow. And I'm just going to smudge that with my finger. Like that. And the same thing I'm going to do with this. To use my Coastal Scents shimmer palette, which is really disgusting. I don't even want to show you guys. But I'm going to use they're all falling. Okay. I'm going to use this color. Hopefully you guys can see it. This color right here in my shimmer palette. And I'm going to use it, and I'm going to put it right where I add that highlight pencil. I'm If you see, it has like a very pink touch to it. I don't know how to explain it. It's very nice. And those are the two shimmery colors that are going to be in your eye. Not too much. And I'm just going to blend that. And there we go. We're going to do our eyebrow. Actually, we're going to do the black inside our eye. We're going to line our eye. Close your eyes, girls, and just smudge that in the top and the bottom. Lash line. Now we're going to put on the bottom as well, because we're going to smudge that. Okay. And we're going to use this palette, and I'm going to use a little bit of this bright purple again. And I'm going to add it right there. It's really hard for me to do a video looking in the camera and not having a mirror in front of me, like, to do it like that. So hopefully you guys do are able to see this. Okay, now I'm going to use the purple right here and a little bit of that one. These two purples. And I'm going to put them right here in the outer part. So that's how that looks. Okay. That phone is terrible. Okay. Okay, that was my husband. All right. We're gonna use a pencil. I'm using the Mary Kay pencil for eyebrow, but you can use anything. I'm not gonna be very harsh on my eyebrow today again. I'm just going to lightly trace it. Remember that your eyebrow has to be right there, start right there, and the highest arch should be right there. Okay, so I want to be soft here because I like it when it starts really soft and gets darker. So that's why I go like that. Oh, here it is. It's the NYX L123. Yeah, 132, I'm sorry. These are the ones that I'm going to use. And for glue, I'm going to be using the Duo.
Make sure the glue dries, okay?
And that's it. So hopefully you guys like it. The eyeliner, I need to fix it a bit, but I don't want this video to be too long. I'm gonna fix it from the front. There we go. I'm gonna get close. I'm gonna close my eye. You guys can see. I really like it. Hopefully she likes it. Hopefully you guys like it. Hopefully you guys try it. If you do, put a picture underneath this video or a comment, and send me pictures if you want. My email is GiselleOrlando@gmail.com.